Hi, I'm Duke.
And I'm Lola.
And this is BossaNova Life.
We are here in Winston, Oregon on this beautiful sunny day.
Mm-hmm. My old hometown.
Yeah.
I grew up here. This used to be a grocery store, and now it's a big antique mall.
Looking for treasure.
Often, and they are correct. It is worth about $600, so they know what they got. What are you looking for?
Looking for pink bathroom stuff. Always a little chalk fish. Maybe a little shelf. I don't know. We'll see. See what we find. Fun stuff.
Oh my goodness. My mom used to have one almost this exact color and everything like that. This is definitely... Yeah, this is definitely, I'd say, 70s would be my guess. Recipe card holder. There you go. What'd you find?
So I found Lazy Susan, which Duke saw and tried to walk away from because he knew I would find it. It's a super good deal.
I may have tried to ignore it because you have so many.
I don't have that many. But this is, I think this is a need, not just a want.
So it's a need, not a want.
We're going with it.
But it is only $29.
Yeah.
So that's about 50% of what you'd pay an hour north of here.
Yeah, I'm taking it. Okay.
Go ahead, pick it up. You like the silvery gold color, you said.
I like the ivory.
And you
like
found another vintage donut maker for our son, well, who's been looking for his. That's supposed to be in the garage, but you may have thrown it away.
I think I may have gotten rid of it. I haven't been able to find it, so he will never know. This one will just show up. But.
Oh my gosh. Cookie Monster would be very happy here. Oh no. Somebody broke a thing. Somebody broke a thing. They broke a thing. What have we got here? There are so many cookie jars. It just goes on and on. Somebody had quite the collection. I don't think I've ever seen something like this. Bandana glasses? I mean, it screams 60s, but I've never seen anything like it. That is an interesting set. A little country flair for your vintage wear. This isn't really vintage, but it's what you're looking at. Future presents
future
for family
presents.
Members.
Yes, and there's a lot of cookie jars here. This one is kind of cute. Not gonna say for who, but yeah.
Somebody might be getting a Christmas present next year.
I don't enjoy cookie jars because I don't eat a lot of cookies, but I like to get them for other people.
Look what I found down here. This is interesting. $18 for a three-piece chip and dip set. Uh-oh. Lola's gonna want to take a look at this one. I may have found you something.
Did Duke find me something? Oh my gosh.
Right here.
It's amazing. He normally tries to lead me right on past these things, but...
Well, it depends on the price.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, this is a good price. And it's pretty cute. I don't think it actually goes in this. At least it doesn't fit well, so...
Yeah, I don't know if this is originally where it came in either.
But I'll take it anyway. Because it's kind of cute.
Yeah, because the base of it is actually octagon.
Yeah. Well, it's a shape. I don't know if it's an octagon.
A roll warmer? Like a vintage roll warmer? So you put your rolls in it and then you cover them up with
this?
Oh
my gosh. Okay, so...
How does that work?
Little story about Lola's family. We have a roll recipe that has been handed down generations. And my mom makes them every
Delicious.
Holiday. They're the best. And we... I think I need to get this for my mom so we have a place to keep our rolls warm. I mean, I think this is a good idea.
It's definitely...
I don't know when it's from, but it will do the job.
Mm, the wood on the ends screams
60s.
The 60s to me, but...
I don't know. I'm still
there
getting
you go.
It.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
these coloring before. That's not painted.
She offered me a shopping basket.
Have you seen Bakelite like this before?
Ooh. It's cute.
It's not painted. It's definitely...
It says it works.
That is interesting.
Yeah, it's cool.
We have one with the original netting, which is really rare. Usually someone else puts some fake modern netting over top of it. That is the original netting on that. That is really nice. I like that. And 100 is a fair price for it. Here we are. I'm like looking at all these clocks, completely distracted, and watch. Leave it to Lola to notice the bedroom set with the bamboo. Oh, the work goes on and on and on, but we will sally forth. I kind of like this moon ornament. That is really cool. Oh wow. They even have some jadeite. That's a very small amount of flour. And why would you want flour to like shake on something? I guess maybe like if you're like rolling things on a countertop, which not too many people do nowadays. $38. They're saying 50s. I think they're probably right. Late 50s, early 60s. It's pretty cool though. I love those colors. 38 is a really good price for those. So now we're hitting the big time here. We got the Rockola. Look at that bad boy. Gorgeous. Of course, the Seaberg. I am a big Seaberg fan. They are always just the style I like. But from what I understand, they're also not worth that much because they're hard to repair. They are so pretty. You found some awesome desks.
Desk, which is super cute. It does need like this glue back. Yeah. And then if you go around the side, it comes with a little cabinet.
It comes with a little cabinet.
A little cabinet.
Oh, that's pretty tight.
Yeah, it's cute. I like it. We don't need it. We just redid our office, or else we may have purchased it. I also am kind of
the luggage
like that
set.
Luggage set, yeah. I don't need it either, but.
Oh wow. It's in really good shape,
yeah.
Though.
Cute. I like the big round one, the back.
Yeah, the hat.
Yeah. It's a cute hat.
Back when ladies used to pack hats. Yeah,
I do really
the snowflake
like that.
Ones are like super popular right now.
And I do really like the black and the white,
yeah,
obviously.
But
it doesn't match up what we're already collecting. And so,
they're very expensive.
This is only $25.
Well, that's a good deal, for sure. Oh.
Follow me.
Well, if I have to.
I have two more down here, actually. So I found this cute little stackable candy dish.
Oh wow, three-layered candy dish.
Isn't that cute? Think of all the candy we can store in there.
Truth.
What would I put in here? I don't even eat candy. I find a way to put candy in there.
If this was old school candy, it would be like butterscotch.
Ooh, it would be something
and
gross.
Like, you know, yeah, fake candy corn.
I love the
They've actually got several of those
around
today.
Well, this one's
today.
Pink, and I haven't seen a pink one.
You do
one.
Like pink.
It's a good, pretty good price, I think.
Lucite, right?
Yeah. Do you think this could go in our kitchen? Pink. We're trying to add more pink to go with our turquoise.
It's up to you, baby.
I think I like it.
You've got the eye for it. You can always spot the mid-century swag.
A cute little pink clock for like a kitchen. We don't need it, but it is pretty cute.
You already got your kitty cat clock. The eyes go...
Yeah, I've got the kitty cats.
Lola can never have enough flamingos.
You can flamenco dance with the flamingos.
That's true.
Oh,
Lord. Finding more dishes.
This is a cute one, and there's a little pink, there's a teapot that matches it in another booth in here, but I don't need that. Although I do like the pink and the gold, I'll be honest.
I'm starting to notice a theme.
There's a theme, there's a theme.
You want a original totem pole?
I have no place to put that.
I mean, I think it's staying out in our living room.
I think
it'd make a statement.
I think it would go through the ceiling in our living room.
That's possible.
Let's be honest.
Hello.
Hey there. We're ready to rock and roll.
Ready to rock and roll.
She's got a clean. She cleaned you guys out.
No. Yes, that's hers.
I can get you. Do it like a like that. Yeah. Yes. Do that right there, like that. Perfect.
Can you take my mask off now?
No, you can't.
We're getting ready to go into this fun little spot.
Day's gone by, baby.
Day's gone
and
by.
We're here that they're going
to
be going out of business.
Yeah,
this
so we
is
have to check
Roseburg's
it out.
OG spot, so mm-hmm. We're going to head in.
We're going to mask it up.
There you go.
Oh, that's cute.
Its little stove is sold, though, unfortunately.
Oh my gosh, but it's so freaking cute.
It would be awesome in a little tiki bar.
Would be?
You've been wanting a little wood stove in there.
I want a little stove in there, yeah. Oh my gosh.
Boop boop be doop. Little fondue action. Oh. Wow. More boop boop be doops. There's a plethora. A plethora of Betty Boops. A plethora of Betty Boops. Would you say that I have a plethora of Betty Boops?
It's not for me.
What you got there?
Oh, it's not. But there is a tree I'm going to ask
That's
about.
A cool purse.
It's like a makeup carrier, but it's not vintage.
Oh, it just looked vintage.
You wanted to close to 100.
But it is a bit cool. I'm sure it's worth it.
What range are you
thinking? I don't think I've ever seen ashtrays like this before. They look like the Partridge Family designed them. That's just interesting to me. The colors and everything on these ashtrays. There is always a lot of Western stuff here if you're looking for vintage Western type things. We're always obviously in the 40s, 50s, 60s, mid-century. But if you're looking for Western, this would be the spot. Ooh. Ship lamp. These would go on TV sets back in the day. And there was, yep, there as you can see it, there's a little light that would like be right behind it. TV lamp. That's what those are. Yeah, that is the dish that you've been collecting. The one in the back. We already have that one at home though. The white one.
Yes.
Lola.
Yeah,
that lady's got no top.
Oh, that's why it says ooh la la.
Oh my goodness. Inappropriate.
Inappropriate.
Inappropriate. They're a lady.
They're a lady with a parasol.
I don't know.
Lovely.
Those are, I don't know what year those are.
There's four of them.
I would say like early 1900s.
Really?
That'd be my guess.
I mean, that's what the little lady looks like, but I don't think the glasses are.
Yeah, I have no idea. It's not. Oh, it's not in my forte.
There's a cool bamboo thing.
I always have a weakness, actually, for the vintage camping gear. That is awesome. Do you see that vintage camping stove over here?
Yeah. It's cute. I like it.
And you found something.
I found something. Okay, so this is pretty amazing. My mask kind of matches it because it's pink.
That's right, baby.
But this is fabulous, I think. I think it's fabulous.
It's in mint condition.
Set. Yes, you have your hamper. And then you've got your little stool to sit on that's nice and cushy for when you do
your
makeup.
Trash can.
And you can put hampery stuff in here too. And then you have your trash can. What a perfect set.
Vintage bathroom set.
Let's buy it. Maybe we don't have a place for it, but it's cute. I like it.
So we've come to Lola's favorite part of all of our videos, which we don't do enough of. People are always asking us to do the little haul section at
yes.
the end. We're going to be doing that this time primarily because we also went and visited Coburg Oregon and went to Retro Rejuvenation, which we didn't get a video of. We didn't have our camera with us at the time. Batteries weren't charged up and all of that. And we got some amazing things there too. So we're going to show you what we found there as well as what we found on this visit.
I'm so excited. So you guys get like 2 weekends worth of our fun, and we got some good stuff.
Lola's always getting the good stuff.
Yeah. So let's get started. So first up from our trip up to Retro Rejuvenation.
Yep. So the gentleman up there at Retro Rejuvenation, he found a bunch of dead stock, unissued fallout shelter signs from the 50s. He had about 30 of them. Of course, I'm going to snap one up for the Atomic Bikini Grotto, because that's what the Atomic Bikini Grotto is all about, was fallout in the Atomic Bikini Grotto in the South Pacific.
Well, yes, the Bikini Atoll, but yes.
The Bikini Atoll.
So, another thing I got, not a big deal so much, but for me it is, I like to collect these cute little aprons. One, I like to wear them when I'm cooking because it makes me feel
housewifey. We do a lot of the crazy retro foods.
But we do like to cook, make our retro food videos. So, I wear these.
And did you get this one yesterday or before that?
I got that in Coburg.
All right.
Yeah. Another thing I got when I was on that trip is this pretty tiki dress. It's pink. It's like Barbie pink, which I'm excited about. It's got these cute little buttons. I like anything with cute buttons.
I like to see you in it.
The hem needs to be hemmed up some, so I might shorten it just a little bit. But we'll see. But one way or another, this will be a regular part
vintage,
of my...
I mean, I'm going to guess mid-60s.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. This is very... the tag, oh, totally. And then it's Liberty House, Lilia Honolulu. So this is beautiful, and
made
it's
made in
pink.
Hawaii. That's and the main pink. Thing you want to know if you want to get the real vintage or at least the retro stuff.
And it's pink and it has buttons.
I scored yesterday. Yeah. I've got some friends in other places that score a lot of vintage, like real vintage tiki shirts more often than I do. Here in Southern Oregon, they're rarer. And what's kind of fun is when you get into these places, the prices aren't so bad. Instead of being like $35, $45 each, I think these are all like $12 each. Almost all of these are either like this. There's no tags. This must have been made by someone, but by the fabric, as I've discussed in some of these before, you can just tell by touching the fabric that this is probably early 70s. But I love them. I'm loving the colors. I might need to get back to my pre-COVID weight to fit into it perfectly. But we'll get there. We'll get there. This one here, Hawaiian original, made in Hawaii.
This one seems kind of 80s to me.
It does.
The rest feel...
probably borderline-y, but yeah. It's just such a great cloth and a good fit. I had to grab it.
It'll be nice to be barbecuing in that.
A lot of blue on this trip.
Yeah.
This one, the tag is completely washed out, as you can see. No way to know when or where this came from, but once again, you could touch it. It's polyester. I'm going to guess late 70s, maybe early 70s from the collar.
Yeah.
Like this one we just saw over here has a short collar. When you got the long collar like this, that's definitely early to mid 70s. And then the same with this one.
This one has got a, excuse me, a different feel to it. This one is like probably 60s, don't you think?
I don't know. It's made by Liberty House, one you had in Hawaii. There we are.
Yeah. I like the pocket on that one.
I do too. Try that one on. Fits perfection.
Why isn't it warm enough to wear this stuff right now?
We need to move to like SoCal or Florida.
Yep. Yep, gonna have to move.
All right, if you've got a job that pays amazingly in those locations, you let us know.
Okay, so when we were in Coburg, we also got some really fun glassware. Do sniff this glassware.
I love like vintage Hawaiian glassware.
This might not be a glassware, actually. Let's get started with...
I don't know if that was... Well, that's not what this is.
So this is kind of fun because we got these like a week ago, so I forgot what I got. But I got these cute little pink salt and pepper shakers. And so these ones were pretty sweet. We're trying to, I like to have a little bit of pink in with my turquoise.
Bakelite.
Yeah, I thought that these were cute. And
straight Bakelite pink salt and pepper shakers. I didn't even know that you got these.
Yeah, I forgot I got them too. So a little bonus.
One's taller than the other. Is that the way you tell the difference? Because there's nothing else that lets you know which one's
salt. I always tell by the number of holes, but there's the same number of holes.
The same. These are funky. I've never seen these before. I've never seen this style in all of my antique adventures. That's fascinating.
Yeah, I'm excited. I can't wait to use them.
I think
them.
These are the mid-century modern ones, which were just amazing that I found. I found a full set of 8 of these up in Coburg. All matching, all pristine. Definitely 60s, late 50s glassware, all gold on gold. No marking, so I don't know who they're from, but they're magnificent.
Yeah, I'm they have them. A lot of the gold.
They don't hold as much as my 70s one does.
Yeah, well, you know, sometimes but you. These I was actually.
You gotta make sacrifices to have an amazing glass. The gentleman who was working there was like, "I know you. I know you're gonna like this." So he ran out and found this one in the back as well, and this is Beach Bum Burt's Redondo Beach.
So covered in palm trees.
I'm gonna buy it. I'm not as much into the cheeky mugs as a lot of people because of limited space. Also, I feel better using these and drinking out of them.
Yes.
What do we got, Lola?
So one of the other things I got,
saw this in the video.
I still haven't figured out how it works yet, but I'm excited to figure out how it works. So I told you in the video that we have a famous family roll recipe.
It's more than famous. It's infamous.
So I'm going to figure this one out, but I'm very excited. It's a bun warmer, automatic bun warmer.
Well, you can 100% tell from the connections, everything that this is 100% made in the USA.
Yeah.
Do not immerse in water.
I wouldn't.
Yeah, who would do that? I don't know. But anyways, yeah.
So I'm 60s. Excited to figure it out.
It doesn't look like it got a lot of use.
I'm excited to figure out how this thing fits on it.
You can warm your buns.
Yeah. Gonna be warming some buns in this thing. I also found this, which we had before. We had it in its original box.
Yeah, we used to have one of these. Like,
it might still be in our garage. With the rest of stuff. I haven't seen it. And my son recently told me that this was his. And then I was like, I don't remember seeing it for a long time.
Our son is on his own now, and he was looking for this donut maker.
Yeah, so it's a donut maker. So I thought, well, it doesn't. I know I still have the original box. I did see that, but I didn't see the donut maker. So we might just secretly put this in, like the hamster that dies, and you get another hamster that looks the same.
Yes.
This might be the same sort of a situation.
So this has no personality. So
it does.
They won't know. He won't know.
We have a lot of white. Fire King.
This is what I was talking about.
Black and white.
An octagon. On
yeah.
The bottom.
Yeah.
And yet it goes in there. But that would make sense to me.
It's a hexagon.
It's pretty good. Why would they? I mean, I don't know. It looks legit to me.
I mean, maybe, but I don't think so.
Like, why would they make one that was that exact shape?
But since we have the Fire King where that is black and white and gold, I thought this would be a nice thing to go along with it when we're having parties. And we can have a little chip and dip set or...
Yeah, I think you're correct, though. Most of the chip and dip sets would have, like this one over here, would have had an offset where it would have sat.
Yeah.
But this is pretty legit. I like it.
I think it's cute. I think it'll go with it.
And for, what was it, like $18, if I remember correctly? Cheap. It was really cheap.
Oh, yeah. They didn't... She asked us if we wanted the prices. We're like, no. But now I kind of wish we would have gotten that price.
That way we don't know.
So that one was a fun one. Trying to remember what else we got. This is fun. It's like Christmas. I don't know what's in here. Ooh, this is my Lazy Susan. I was really excited because I love the colors. Again, a lot of these are bright colors, and I like the bright colors too, but the gold and the white just kind of go with my aesthetic.
It spoke to me.
Unless it was turquoise or pink, this is just as good. So
There was a turquoise and pink set, by the way, at Retro Rejuvenation in Coburg, which we were also at, which we didn't have the video for, but the price was a little too steep for our blood. Yeah. No, it wasn't Retro Rejuvenation. It was at Time Travelers in Springfield. We go to a lot more antique shops than we let you guys ever see.
We got some good stuff. We found some other stuff that I really liked also, but we don't really have room for it, so... Sometimes we'll show you some of the fun stuff we find, but we don't take home.
We love antiquing. We love thrifting because it's like gambling, except that you win.
Mm-hmm.
With gambling, you're just throwing money out and you're spending money and you never get anything back. With antiquing, whatever we buy, we like, right?
Yeah,
and sometimes we just don't find
like
anything.
It.
So the worst case scenario is we spend some gas.
Yeah.
Versus pulling the slots down. So
yeah.
But otherwise, there you go.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Cheers.
Thank you.